Today we'll talk about post-baccalaureate programs for premeds. If you've decided to pursue a career in medicine but are not yet a competitive applicant, you're probably aware that post-baccalaureate programs can help you improve your candidacy for medical school. But how do you know if attending a post-bacc program is right for you? I'm Dr. Mindy Hoffman, a medical school admissions expert at Shemassian Academic Consulting. In this video, I'll describe the ideal candidate for post-baccalaureate programs and go over the different considerations you should make when deciding whether to apply. We'll also talk about special master's programs and whether these programs are looked upon more favorably by admissions committees. Then I'll share helpful admissions strategies so that you can get into your ideal program. Let's get started. What is a pre-med post-baccalaureate program? Post-baccalaureate programs are 1 to 2 year programs designed for students who already have an undergraduate degree and want to enhance their application to become more competitive to medical school. Through post-bacc programs, students have the opportunity to either take the prerequisites they still need to apply to medical school or retake the courses in which they earned low grades. Many programs also provide students with MCAT support and opportunities to obtain the requisite clinical and research experiences for medical school. It's important to note that in post-baccalaureate programs, you'll be taking undergraduate-level courses. This means that the grades you earned in post-bacc courses will count towards the undergrad GPA that will be reported on your medical school application. Remember, in general, when applying to medical school, you'll want your GPA to fall within the range of accepted students at your target school. If your GPA falls below the range for most of your target schools, this could be a great option for you. However, you'll also need to be mindful of the number of undergraduate credits you have. The more undergraduate credits you've accumulated, the less of an impact your post-bacc courses will have on your GPA, even if you achieved high grades. An additional benefit that post-bacc programs provide is the opportunity to develop relationships with professors who can write strong letters of recommendation. If you've lost touch with professors from undergrad, this could help strengthen your candidacy since these letters will reflect your most recent academic performance. Career changers versus record enhancers. Most post-baccalaureate programs fall into one of two main categories: the career changer category or record enhancer category. Career changer programs are designed for students who arrived at the decision to apply to medical school late in their undergraduate careers or after graduation. These students tend to be non-science majors and typically haven't taken the prerequisite courses such as physics and organic chemistry. Record enhancing programs are designed for students who were pre-med during college but underperformed in their undergraduate courses, usually the sciences. A school's website will indicate whether a program is designated for career changers or record enhancers. Special master's programs. Special master's programs, or SMPs, are similar to post-baccalaureate programs in that they're also 1 to 2 year programs designed to help you become a more competitive medical school applicant. However, there are several key differences between SMPs and post-bacc. The first difference is that you must complete all of the medical school prerequisites in order to apply to an SMP. So this will not be an option for career changers who haven't completed med school prereqs. The second difference is that SMPs are master's degree granting programs, which means you'll be taking graduate level courses alongside medical students. The grades you earn in these courses will not count towards your undergrad GPA that's reported to medical school. Instead, the grades you earn in SMP courses will count towards a separately reported graduate GPA. SMP courses are typically just as rigorous as medical school courses, and therefore give ADCOMS confidence in your ability to perform well as a med student. Many SMPs also require students to complete a research thesis. This can be beneficial if you lack research experience. Students often ask me, which program is better, a post-bacc or an SMP? But the truth is, the answer completely depends on your unique circumstances. If you're a pre-med who has all of the med school prereqs but can't decide between a post-bacc or an SMP, the main consideration should be your GPA in conjunction with your MCAT. Let's take a look at some example scenarios in which the best choice might not be clear. John was an engineering major in college, and after earning his bachelor's degree, decided that he wanted to go to medical school. His GPA is a 3.1 and he hasn't yet taken the MCAT. In this case, because John's GPA is low, he should enroll in a post-bacc program and achieve at a high level in his coursework. Because he has not yet taken the MCAT, a post-bacc program that provides students with MCAT support would be ideal. Here's another example. Anita is a bio major with a 3.7 GPA who graduated from college 4 years ago. She recently scored a 502 on the MCAT. In this case, Anita has completed all of the med school prereqs with high grades. However, her MCAT score is on the lower side for USMD programs. Additionally, it's been several years since she graduated from college, and ADCOMS will have a difficult time determining whether she is academically prepared for medical school. Because Anita's GPA is high enough for med schools, a post-bacc program would not improve her profile in a meaningful way. In her case, it would make more sense to enroll in an SMP and retake the MCAT to show recent high performance. Linkages. An advantage of doing a formal post-bacc or SMP is that some programs have what are called linkages, or agreements with medical schools to admit or interview qualified students. For example, Columbia University Post-Bacc Program has linkage agreements with over a dozen schools, including NYU Medical School and Weill Cornell. You'll need to meet certain GPA or MCAT and course requirements to be eligible for linkage acceptance. A key advantage to attending a program that has a linkage agreement in place is that students can matriculate into partnering medical schools the fall after completing the post-bacc, which eliminates the need for a glide year. Programs with linkage agreements tend to be more difficult to get into, but once you're in, it can increase your odds of getting into medical school. Considerations. The AAMC lists 233 post-baccalaureate programs on its site. With so many to choose from, how do you decide which one is right for you? You'll want to look at a program's cost, length, and your eligibility. Post-bacc programs are costly and typically run in the tens of thousands of dollars. Beyond that, what does the post-bacc program offer to you? If you're just starting on your pre-med journey, would you benefit more from a structured program that provides support to students like you? Are there several courses in which you struggled, and would it be possible to retake these classes on your own through an extension program? Post-baccalaureate programs are expensive, and oftentimes the DIY or do-it-yourself approach can save you thousands of dollars in tuition costs. Post-baccalaureate programs for pre-meds, how to get in. If you have a low GPA, don't panic. Remember, post-bacc programs are specifically designed to help students with low GPAs. If you meet the minimum GPA requirements, consider yourself eligible for a program. Next, you'll want to write a compelling personal statement to convince them that this program is the missing piece of the puzzle that you need to get into medical school. As a bonus, writing the personal statement for post-baccalaureate programs will give you great practice for medical school application season. In fact, you might even be able to recycle your essay for your medical school application. Like the medical school personal statement, you'll want to discuss how your experiences and how your unique qualities make you qualified for a career in medicine. However, for non-traditional students, you'll also want to describe how your non-medical experiences have led you to medicine. In addition to the personal statement, there are two other common essay prompts that you may encounter when applying to post-bacc programs. The first is the Why Us essay prompt. Post-bacc programs know that you're applying so that you can improve your application for medical school. What they want to know is what elements of their program align with your own interests in medicine. The second prompt you might encounter is the academic performance essay, which will ask you to list your academic deficiencies, reasons why you underperformed, and whether you've made the appropriate changes to set yourself up for success in medical school. The key here is to be completely transparent without making excuses for yourself. Final thoughts. Attending a pre-med post-baccalaureate program is a tried and true way to gain acceptance into medical school, but it's still a highly personal decision that will require you to evaluate all of your strengths and weaknesses as a medical school applicant. If you can convince post-bacc admissions committees that you will be successful in their program, you'll be one step closer to achieving your medical school dreams. If you found this video to be helpful, hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed yet, you can do that here so you don't miss out on new videos. If you'd like to learn more about medical school admissions, you can also click the link in the description below to get a free copy of our guide, How to Get into Medical School, which contains all of the strategies we use to help students get into top medical schools like Johns Hopkins, Mayo, and UCLA. All right, thanks so much for watching. See you next time.